opponent has the hands too low, I can't do the following technique, because it is a technique that requires eye level with high hands. And it happens frequently, at least to us, when in free play, you start a complicated situation just like this. If we are in a situation like this, we again release the left hand. Again, we do something with the pelvis. This time again, we just jump from this, releasing the left hand. The pelvis almost automatically jumps in between his hands. Between his hands, if you imagine that, where the goblet is, if you did, sometimes it just doesn't work. And now, you might have guessed it, you catch your blade again, and with a step, a push, and a pull motion, you have him convinced to lose the fight. And if you pull here, you can make it even more convincing. Okay, again. We enter the fight. Falko is so kind to that thing, and I'm not in the mood of being rushed in, and therefore I bring him to the ground. So the other way, the other side. Do it slowly, because in the beginning it might be a bit tricky to find the right moment for the hand to be released in order to for the pommel to pass through your partner's arms. And well, in the beginning, and I just showed it for the first time, sorry, I actually did let my sword drop considerably. I don't do that, of course. I catch it in mid-air. I don't let the point show down, actually. So it's a very quick motion and movement. Again, you don't do nothing. And so it is from the eye-level situation, just something like that. Very, very slow, not slow, very, very small, fluent motion. Just like he tries to lauf in,